Hey guys, it's Emma. Today I'm going to be doing a monthly spread with you. I know it is a little bit late because we are already in April, but I am going to be doing a April monthly spread today using the kit from Planning Roses. It's such a beautiful kit. It's a wooden kit with shades of purple and woods, and it's just absolutely gorgeous. So I'm going to get started and jump straight into this. The first thing I'm going to do is pop down my header up the top. So we have the April one first. I'm going to go down and hopefully this will go down straight. So good so far. The worst thing with big stickers as they can be a little bit sticky to get down, a little bit hard to get down straight, but what's good with hers is they're removable matte, so it's not too bad. So that's that one there, and then I'll pop this one down on this side. Awesome. This already looks better already. So, my man, if you wanted to, you probably could leave it like that, and that already looks nicer. But anyway, next thing to do, I'm going to pop down the Days of the Week cover. So that just goes straight down on top there. What's the stick? The worst thing about it is where this April bit is this month. Makes it a little bit tricky to stick this down. Come on. Okay, cool. Awesome. There we go. Hopefully next month, because I've already pre-ordered her one for May. Hopefully I get May's kit before May starts so that I can actually have this up, the May one up before May comes around. I did look at getting Elle's like Glam Planner monthly kit, but I've used all of Planning Roses throughout my planner and I kind of wanted it all to match, like with March, like she had the wooden theme and then she still got the wooden theme. They kind of just flow a little bit, so I wanted to keep that all kind of like corresponding and the same. So for this here, she comes with a little blackout bit. I did actually see Andrea from Scribble Prints Co. What she did the other day was she actually used where it's blacked out and put a and use them for like little lists, like if you needed an extra room for different types of things. So like if you had, I don't know, something that you didn't want to put in the sidebar, you've got the room in the header. And I was like, that's an awesome idea. Like, that is such a clever idea to use like the blackout days as little like lists. So she also includes, sorry, getting off track. She also includes some little blackout boxes, so you can black out certain days where you don't want to do anything for the month. I'm going to use one of those to black out this one here, which is the month before. I'm now going to go through and pop down my stickers for April Fool's Day and Earth Day. So April Fool's Day is obviously the 1st of April, so I'll stick that down. And what I love, oopsies, about her stickers, like her monthly ones, is they have the date on them, which I think is an awesome idea. Like, it's a great idea. I love that. Awesome idea. Okay, so next thing I might do is pop down my payday. So I get paid every single Wednesday. There's only one Tuesday where I'm going to be paid. So I'm going to pop all of my payday stickers down. Yeah, I get paid every single Wednesday, which makes it easy. I will actually have to use one of like these ones or these ones here for my other paid, my other, oh, that's a bill due, whoops, my other payday, because the kit's got four paydays. Thank you. Awesome, this already looks so cute, I love it. Oh, sorry guys, I've been a little bit sick, so if I cough, I am sorry. Okay, next thing I might do is pop down my sidebar. So we've got the monthly to-dos. And I know some people as well like to white out what's underneath all of this, but I actually haven't found a problem with Jenna's stickers, like anything poking through, which is awesome. It's a quite thick, but I mean, like if it was if it was quite a like white sticker, you'd probably have to white some bits out. But I find with Jenna's, it's all pretty good. That has not gone down properly. Oh well. So I might do my sidebar lightest to darkest. Yeah. Lightest to darkest. Let's put some of those down. Next one. She also changed the sidebar for this month. So it used to be one massive strip of sticker like the ones at the top, but she actually changed it so that it's just four individual stickers. And I mean, I think that's a good idea because sometimes like larger stickers can be a little bit problematic to pop down. I do like that. Awesome. So I'm going to pop down my headers. So I might do month's purchases first. I do like that she includes headers as well. Like that's an awesome one. I'm gonna do month's bills. The one at the bottom I'm going to do is month's memories. I think that's such a super cute way, like thing to add. It's so cute. Like that's an awesome idea. I love that. And then that one there. Purchases, bills, memories. I might put mail because for April, I'm actually doing one where I'm not buying too much. I'm trying to limit my spending because I go onto Etsy and I just go nuts. So I'm trying to limit my spending for April. Anyway, next thing, I'll pop down my last one for the payday for the 12th. Which shade should I use this one here? So I'll pop this one here down on the 12th. And I'll just put a little dollar sign there. Signify payday. That's payday. So on the 2nd was my graduation. I've already had my graduation, so it's in the past. So I'll pop that there down for graduation, and I might pop a present. Yeah, I'll put a present on that to signify that. On the 23rd, I have a breast cancer ball, which I'm going to, so I'll pop that down, and I might put a love heart on that. I know a lot of people like to match up the colours, but I kind of like it when they're different colours. So on the 11th, school holidays start, so I might pop down one for the school holidays because that's when they start, and I'll just use an asterisk. Okay, fantastic. So that's school going back, that's all of that done. What else can I pop down on this? It's the 1st, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, and 8th was school. I've also got school on the 26th and 27th. So how many of these do I have left? So one, that's 5, 6. 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Awesome, there's 8 left altogether. Cool, I won't do one on the 1st. One down for the 4th. Oh, will I put those down? Yeah. 4th. Fifth, 6th, 7th, and 8th. Awesome, so there's school, and then the 26th and the 27th I've also got to school. So that says school returns, so I'll just put school returns and then like a thing that I'm working up day two. I might actually go ahead now and pop down all of the date covers. So what's really cool is this month she actually included date covers, which obviously if you don't want to do it, you don't have to, but I do like to pop them down. I think it's just like another little element to add to your monthly spread, something really cute. Okay, cool. So I've stuck all of those down. I did actually end up blocking out 2 days. I've blocked out the 17th and the 25th. The 25th is a public holiday, but I don't want to be doing anything that day. And then the 17th, I kind of just want to have like a day where it's like, phew, nothing to do. So awesome. So those 2 days I have completely blocked out of my month. I want to be doing nothing on those days, just hanging out and chilling. I think I've pretty much got everything down that I need to so far for this month, except for my bills due. Okay, so I always have my phone bill due at the end of the month, which is on the 28th. Oh. Well, that I struggled so much, just then I put that down to get it straight and didn't even go down straight. Anyway, so bill due on the 28th. I have a my gym will come out on the 4th. I have my car repayment, which I believe comes out on the exact same day. That is direct debited straight out of my account, so makes it easy. And then on the last day of the month is normally when I pay off my credit card, but I do like to pay it off on the day that I get paid, which is a Wednesday. So awesome. So I think that's everything that I need for this month so far. I've used up basically every sticker apart from the dots on this one. Everything except for the teardrops and like the little two extra headers. And then this one here, pretty much all of them except for like the blackout ones. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through and fill this out and I'll be back. Okay guys, so that is my month at a glance plan. I think it turned out really, really cute. I absolutely adore the colours that she has used and I cannot wait until her May, till I get her May kit in the mail. I hope you guys liked it. Make sure to give it a thumbs up and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!